guys, and welcome to Mark Shrimp Tanks. Today I'm going to let you into a little secret, and this is a secret that I've found that only really a few people know about, and it's a way to make your shrimp live longer. And basically what this is, guys, is you will all have had this red-headed shrimp disease. I'm going to call it a shrimp disease because it's a bacterial infection within the shrimp that is caused by a Vibrio species of gram-negative bacteria, right? All you guys have probably had this before. You get one shrimp in your tank and it dies and its head goes red. Now, I've heard different people say this different ways, like it's the gut in the shrimp that is liquefying basically, and this is why it goes red. Well, what actually is happening is there's bacteria in the organs of the shrimp's head that kills the shrimp, okay? So there's ways to stop this, and I've been researching this for quite a long time because I've had this in a few tanks, and it's one of those things, once you get the Vibrio species of bacteria in your tank, when the levels of bacteria are too high, because basically I think in the tanks it's always present, right? But there are, when it gets to a certain level, when it's too high, you start to see a cascade effect of shrimp deaths. Right, so you get one shrimp in your tank dead. You come over. This is why it's important when you see a dead shrimp in your tank. It's important that you remove the dead shrimp, because the chances are, if it's died from this Vibrio bacterial infection, the other shrimp will eat it. Right, and then that bacterial infection gets passed on to the next shrimp, and this is where the cascade effect happens, because then that shrimp will die, and if it dies behind something that you don't see and you don't remove it, it continues. Right, I've had this. This knock-on effect on quite a few tanks, quite a few times. You guys probably haven't seen it. Like in this tank, I've had it at least twice, but I've lost about 100 shrimp. And this one here, twice. And the shrimp always make a recovery, right? So I've wanted to stop this from happening, right? So there's a few ways you can do this. The soaking oxidator is one. I know for sure that it sterilizes the water as it cleans it, basically. So that is one way you can stop the spread of Vibrio in a tank. And this is another way I've found. After research, I finally found a way. I found this a couple of months ago, and you're going to get to see what it is. I will leave a link in the description from the paper describing what you actually do, and I'm going to show you the way that I've actually modified it a little bit for myself, right? In the paper, it basically said if you use some kind of formic acid dosed into the food, it reduces the count of Vibrio species of bacteria in the shrimp's gut, right? So it makes them live longer. Right? Combined with another thing, I'm going to mention this as well, Astaxanthin is also known to reduce Vibrio infections in tanks. And I don't specifically have Astaxanthin here, but it is in some of my food, right? So I'm just going to go over some of them. Astaxanthin is present in a lot of foods that say they have kelp in it or red algae, okay? I know this one does, Day by Day does. I know all of these do have some kind of Astaxanthin in them. Let's see. This is a very good one here. This is Shrimp Baby. I think this is like 30% Astaxanthin. It's very red. Dinerla Colour here. I do not have an agenda against you. One of your employees said I have. This proves that I use it. I'm promoting this product. This also is very high in Astaxanthin. Kingfish over here is one of my favourite foods as well. It also has krill meal in it, which means it has Astaxanthin. Right, so you want to combine your Astaxanthin dosing with this thing I'm going to show you, okay? So basically once or twice a week, right, you're going to feed your normal foods. One of them will have Astaxanthin in it. And this is the other one. The study I just showed you guys, that I'm going to leave in the description, the study I just showed you guys is for formic acid, right? So part of citric acid is formic acid. So I have citric acid here. Now my dosing is not very scientific. I've had to I don't know what you'd call this, like eyeball it and hope for the best kind of thing, but it works, okay? So I have this is a kilo of citric acid. You can buy this from loads of places. I got this off eBay from a country I've used before, Hexel, for various things. But all I did with this, guys, was I used citric acid. I used a teaspoon of this stuff here into this little container. I think this holds 50 milliliter. And I put some RO water here and I gave it a good shake. Right, and this basically is something that tastes super sour. I've tasted this as well. I wanted to see what it was like, because the shrimp are going to have to eat this, okay? This is the way I do it. I have my shrimp food here. This is a little piece of Mark's nettle mix. By the way, guys, you probably will have noticed as well, I've made Mark's nettle mix a little bit smaller, because this is how much food I reckon 20 shrimp should have every 1 to 2 days. Okay, my pieces I had before were a little bit bigger, I think. You still, if you buy this off me, by the way, guys, you still get the same amount, it's just a little bit smaller. Okay, so you're shaking up your citric acid formula, and what you want to do is you want to put one drop right in the center, and then leave it, right? And this is going to soak in. Normally, this for this, my food, that takes about 10 minutes for it to soak in completely. And then you're going to put it into your tank. Now, I just want to warn you guys beforehand, the shrimp will race to this, but often they will touch it and then they will back off of it. And I think until the citric acid is diluted enough off of the food, they won't eat it because it is so acidic. But as long as they get some of the citric acid into their system, it is beneficial for them, okay? And this is how you beat Vibrio infections in a shrimp tank. Okay, if you have any questions, please feel free to ask me in the comment section below, because I know this will help loads and loads of you guys, because this is one of the things I've always struggled with, is this type of Vibrio infection. You remember here last year I had a tank, this was King Kong's pandas, remember, and wine reds. This whole tank was just King Kong's and I lost loads of them. This was through a Vibrio infection. Over here I had if you guys will remember as well, I had a tank that was about 40 orange-eyed blue tigers. I lost a load of them as well. I think I lost about 2/3 of them, and this was also through a Vibrio infection. In this tank specifically, some of the orange-eyed blue tigers, their heads were going red while they were still alive, right? So this shows that it isn't just a case of the organs liquidating and then them dying. Is the Vibrio affecting them while they're still alive, okay? And since I've done this, guys, I've done this for the past 2 months, I haven't seen a single dead shrimp with this type of infection on it. You will see, if you ever have this, you will know which one I'm talking about, okay? So I hope that's been of some use. I know it will be of a lot of use to a lot of you guys. This tank is absolutely gorgeous today. I have lots of orange tangerine tigers in here. I think one of the girls is molted because they're having a little race around the tank. And that is my video today. Okay, guys? Thank you for watching. Catch you in the next one. Bye-bye, Vibrio! No more deaths! Bye!